In this video, I want to talk about superelastic property and the plasticity in these materials. In the previous video, I talked about the ABAQUS 2019 and your version, which there is a new facility, and we don't need to write any subroutine in order to model the shared memory alloys. And in this video, I want to talk about the plasticity in these materials, and in the ABAQUS 2019 and newer versions, we don't need to write any subroutine to model the plasticity in these materials. And I want to show this facility in a specific example, a bar that is under axial compression. I have used my data from this article. The material property is available in this article. I have used it, and also the cross section of my material, my geometry is a square with 12 millimeter dimension and length of 145 millimeter, and I want to show you in my modeling. And at the end of the model, and after we run the model and show the result, we can extract the stress strain curve, and we can see the plasticity in the geometry after the axial load. So I come here and define a geometry. So I enter the value of 12 for both dimensions. Maybe I come here and then, okay. So I come here and enter the length. Okay, I come here in the property. I have talked about the superelasticity of these materials. We can come here and we choose this option, and we can model the superelasticity here. I have explained it in the previous video, but my goal in this video is another new facility of these materials, and this is the plasticity, the superelastic hardening. Here we can choose and enter the values that is available at the points after the end of transformation for loading. And I have 2 points data. If you have more data, your model is more exact, and we can see the results. It is closer to the experimental result, and our simulation will be better. So I have these 2 data, so I want to enter them here, the yield stress and also strain, and I want to enter them. So, and another option is super hardening modification, where elastic hardening modifications. These 4 values are same, which have been entered here. And just plastic strain is new option. So I re-enter the value which are similar to this part. The start of transformation is 450, end is 700, and start of transformation for unloading is 200, and also the end of transformation for unloading is 30. And also I want to enter the plastic strain 0.15. it depends on your material, and you can enter the value that is available about your material. So I press OK. My property have been completed, and I have defined a section before for this geometry. I choose here and my allocate the section 1 to my material. I come to a step. I assemble my geometry, and then I come to a step. I have defined a step, a buckle step, in order to model the axial compression at the next model, not this model. So I come here and I check if the variables are okay. The field outputs will be checked. Okay, I come here and come to the interaction. I want to define a rigid body at two ends. So before defining a rigid body, I want to define an interaction. So I come here and find the central point of the cross section at each end. So I enter the value and define it. Similarly, at the another end, I choose and offset 6, minus 6 here, minus 6, and choose this point and allocate the reference point here. And I want to define a constraint, a rigid body constraint, and choose the reference point 3, and also tie the surface to this reference point and do it similarly at the another end. So I do the same action here and I want to complete my, sorry, there is some problem, so I again do it. A point must, a time must be here. Okay, my action have been completed. I come here, I define a load here. Two boundary conditions will be defined. In this point, all of the degrees of freedom have been closed. And in this point, all of boundary condition except in Z direction here will be closed. So I do, and then I want to define a load. Actually, for step one, it is very important to define a load for step one. And I click here and choose minus one. The value is not important, but I prefer to choose minus one. And I come to the mesh. I choose the distance of seeds, global seeds, actually 4 millimeter, and press OK and mesh my geometry. And also I choose the geometry and check the mesh type. C3D8R is OK. So I continue my modeling. Before creating job and submit it, we must change the keywords. At the end part we must erase and add star node file and U. Okay, these are not necessary. Okay, there is no problem. So actually we must add these words, star node file and U. And also I want to create job 1, and I want to check the data first. I check the data and then I check if it is correct or not. And the data is correct. So after the checking data, I want to submit my job. So I submit it and then we can copy this model, and some changes will be occurred on the next model, and then submit the model to, for example, again. Okay, we can see the result actually, but it is not important for us, but we can see the result. Okay, we must copy the model. I name it model 2. I come here. I want to take some changes in my model in a step. First of all, here I want to replace this step to the static general one. So I come here and take these changes. The maximum number, the initial value must be changed, and also the maximum and minimum will be changed. Okay, these changes are okay. I want to edit the filled out request and check whether these are okay or not. And also force, and we can see and can add contact. These are okay. So I want to come here on the load and delete this load and add a displacement here. I want to add a displacement at the reference point at the point which all of the boundary condition except in Z direction was closed. So I choose this point, and the value of the displacement is not important, but it must be high, because in a static general step the displacement is higher than the another analysis type. The length of my bar is 145, so I choose minus 50. For example, you can choose, for example, minus 70 or minus 100 and test the result. But in this modeling, I want to choose minus 50. I press OK, and that is the end of the changes. Before submitting my model, I want to change the keyword in model 2. It is very necessary to change it. And also delete the U not file, and also these are not good, and I want to remove them. So I come here, and before the step we must add these words. So star imperfection file equal to this one is the name of the job which have been run the previous model, and step equal 1 and 0.2. this refers to imperfection, maybe 1000 times smaller than the length of our part, but 0.2 is okay for this model. Maybe it is good choice. So I want to enter the imperfection. Okay, it is very important to enter the words correctly. Imperfection file equals to job 1, and also a step equals to 1 and 1 2 e minus 1. I come to the another line and press OK. So I check the data if it is correct or not. Maybe I must define another model. So I come here and check the data. Before the running of the model, to find if there is a problem to the input file or not. Maybe I have entered the keyword incorrectly. Maybe in spelling. So I tried again. Imperfection. And that is so on. And maybe come to, that's okay. Come to another line is better. So I do it. I check it again. Okay, the problem has been fixed. So I can submit my job, and after the analysis we can see the results. So I submit my job. And we can also monitor the running here. We can monitor the path that is have been occurs occurred and will be occur. And we can see the step time. If the step time reaches to the 1, the analysis will be completed. And it takes some time. Okay, the job have been completed. I come to the results. So we can see our model's deflection, but this is not necessary for us. We want to just extract the axial deformation for unique nodal. I want to extract the reaction force and also at this end at the reference point that have been allocated all of the nodes at the surface here, this reference point here, and extract the reaction force. Node set 14 is this point. We can find the node sets here to choose the correct one. Here we can see set 13 is here and also set 14, set 12 is here. So I have choose the set 14. Set 12 and set 14 are same. I edit, choose edit, and copy all of these values. We can enter these values here and do the same action for the axial displacement for set 13 and plot the result and see the data here and copy them. I add them here. Actually, we can change the axial displacement to axial strain by dividing them to the initial length, and actually the positive value is our result, and we must change it to the positive ones. Also, we can change the axial force to the axial stress and by dividing the value into the cross-section area, it is 144 in my example. Also, the positive value is our goal to calculate, so I change them to the positive. And also, we can draw a stress strain curve here, and we can see the result here. Maybe near the 450, we can see the start of transformation. In 700, the transformation ends. At the point of 1100, rarely we can see this value according to this graph, and also the strain of 0.125 here, and also at the point of 0.25, we can see the another point that we have entered in the input file, and the strain of 0.25. We can actually see the plasticity effect here, and we can extract the stress strain curve by using this new facility in the ABAQUS 2019 and newer versions, and many applications will be used and modeled by this new facility. And in this video, I want to show you a simple example of the plasticity effect on the, for example, sample, a bar sample. And you can model the further samples, and it depends on your goal and on your loading condition and so on.